Sansara Sagare Magnam
Sansara Sagare Magnam
Deenam Maam
Deenam Maam
Karunanidhe
Karunanidhe
Karma Moha
Karma Moha
Grihitangam
Grihitangam
Maamuddhara
Maamuddhara
Bhavarnavat
Bhavarnavat
Shrimat
Srimad
Bhagavatakshoyam
Bhagavatakshoyam
Pratyaksha
Pratyaksha
Krishna Evahi
Krishna Evahi
Svikritosi
Svikritosi
Mayanatha
Mayanatha
Muktyartham
Muktyartham
Bhavasagare
Bhavasagare
Manoratho
Manoratho
Madiyoyam
Madiyoyam
Safala
Safala
Sarvathatvaya
Sarvathatvaya
Nirvignenaiva
Nirvignenaiva
Kartavyo
Kartavyo
Dasoham
Dasoham
Tavakeshava
Tavakeshava
Shukarupa
Shukarupa
Prabodhagnya
Prabodhagnya
Sarvashastra
Sarvashastra
Visharada
Visharada
Etatkatha
Etatkatha
Prakashena
Prakashena
Madagnyanam
Madagnyanam
Vinashaya
Vinashaya
Vande
Vande
Nandavrajastrinam
Nandavrajastrinam
Padarenum
Padarenum
Abhikshnashaha
Abhikshnashaha
Yasam
Yasam
Harikathodgitam
Harikathodgitam
Punati
Punati
Bhuvanatrayam
Bhuvanatrayam
Vande
Vande
Nandavrajastrinam
Nandavrajastrinam
Padarenum
Padarenum
Abhikshnashaha
Abhikshnashaha
Yasam
Yasam
Harikathodgitam
Harikathodgitam
Punati
Punati
Bhuvanatrayam
Bhuvanatrayam
By the grace of the Lord on your behalf and my own, we first thank Lord Krishna and Mother Radha Rukmini for giving us this opportunity to listen to the Bhagavatam. Give the Lord a big applause, please. But for him, we cannot have anything lovely in the world. Last evening, we beheld a glimpse of the Rasalila. The Rasalila goes on and on and on for several nights. Even as you think of the Rasalila, the ecstasy lingers. There is a nice paddhati in Kerala. It is called Bhagavata Satram. I hope you know the Keralites read the Bhagavatam every day. The women know the Moolapatam. They do the Moolapatam every day. And in Kerala, you have 7 days Satram. Satram is a yaga. For every subject, they call one speaker. For every subject, every episode. And usually, I am the only non-Malayalam speaking English speaker who is called for the Satram, wherever it is held. And generally, I'm giving 2 hours. 2 hours for the Rasa Leela, you can imagine. And still, I'm not satisfied. How can I do justice in half an hour, tell me? The gopis of Vrindavan had danced with the Lord. Even to think of their dance, you feel ecstatic. Imagine dancing with the Lord. Akhandanji Maharaj Sri, my Manasik Guru, for your information, he was the editor of the Gita Press translations. He was the one who gave so many books to the world. This great man used to say that the Rasalila goes on and on for several nights and the gopis are still in dizzy height. There is no doubt about it. The Rasa is performed by the Lord only to give joy to man. The gopis had had so much of ecstasy that after the Rasalila is over, you know the 5 adhyayas describe the Rasalila, after it is over, they're recollecting emotion and tranquility. And they're standing together in an isolated place, looking at each other, praising the Lord, praising the music, thinking of him with all their heart and soul. My dear listeners, whenever I think of the Sanskrit language, I'm emotional because that is the language that brings us close to the scriptures. And the scriptures are the records of God-man relationship in our India. Bharat has recorded through Sanskrit this God and man bondage or bonding as you call it. Whenever I think of Sanskrit, I say, my God, how vibrant this language is. The gopis are now reciting 2 shlokas together. It's called the Yugala Gita. And I tell my audience, that this Yugala Gita has so much of self-contained music. First, I will read it without the rhythm of Shambhai's tabla. And after that, second time I recite, he will play on the tabla. And you'll see how much music is there within the shloka. We don't add music, we only discover the music. I hope you understand. That is the language, the Deva Bhasha that is there. I hope you have observed flute players. The flute player does not hold the flute like that. It's like this. And then he knits his brows. Then looks at the notches. And the nimble fingers move as the breath passes through the notches and creates lovely music. If you and I did it, it would be foo-foo. Only the flute player knows how to do it. And sometimes they keep the rhythm, tala, with their foot. The music season is fast approaching. That's how the flute player learns to play on the flute. And who taught him? The primordial flute player called Krishna, Sakala Kala Adi Guru Hu Nanartha. Look at the way the gopis are graphically describing the flute player of Vrindavan.
Vama Bahu Krita Vama Kapolu Valgita Bru Adhararpita Venum Kumalangulibhir Ashrita Margam Gopya Irayati Yatra Mukunda.
This is a plain recitation. Now with the tabla, you'll see how much there is of the rhythm in it.
Vama Bahu Krita Vama Kapolu Valgita Bru Adhararpita Venum Kumalangulibhir Ashrita Margam Gopya Irayati Yatra Mukunda.
How did you like it? So much of music, so much of Talabadha. The language is Talabadha. There is so much of music contained within Sanskrit. You don't have to add music, you just discover the music.
Vama Bahu Krita Vama Kapolo Valgita Bru Adhararpita Venum Kumalangulibhir Ashrita Margam Gopya Irayati Yatra Mukunda.
The gopis are talking about the Lord. They've forgotten everything about the world, thinking of Him. But all good things have to come to an end. Everything can't go on and on. After that, you have to live the memories of the lovely experience. The Lord has decided, according to His avatara, He has to go to Mathura. And the killing of Kamsa, thereafter Sadhu Paritrana and Dushtanigraha has to start. The great one called Akrura is sent. He's sent to bring Sri Krishna and Balarama under the pretext of a beautiful Utsavam that is going on. Actually, it's a death trap for the children. Kamsa wants to kill both these children who are performing several miracles in Braja, in Vrindavana. That is why Akrura is sent. Akrura is like one of the devout officers. Akrura is asked, go to Vrindavan, that's all. He doesn't ask for the before and after. He wants to see Krishna. He wants to see Krishna. He hurries there. Everybody says his Manoratha went first and then his Ratha followed. His heart went first and then the chariot followed. When he meets Sri Krishna, he doesn't know how to react to the Lord's beauty and lovely welcome. He's bringing back Krishna in the chariot. And as he is bringing back Krishna in the chariot, there's the first road roku, first strike. And that is by the gopis. The gopis are holding hands, stopping the way. Akrura, who called you Akrura? You must be called Paramakrura. You're taking away our life and soul. Who will play on the flute from tomorrow? Who will steal butter and steal hearts? Who will give us the joy of life? Who will play the Rasa Leela with us? Don't take him. Master, don't go away. It's difficult for people to express their emotions in public, but sometimes overwhelming emotions have to be expressed. And that is why the gopis are crying. How do they cry? Musically, sonorously. Bhagavata records,
evam bruvana virahatura brisham vrajastriya కృష్ణ విశక్త మానస విసృజ్య లజ్జాం రురుదు స్మ సుస్వరం గోవింద దామోదర మాధవీతి గోవింద.
That is the Pallavi, which is taken for the Govinda Damodara Stotra from the Bhagavatam.
Govinda Damodara Madhaveti, Govinda Damodara Madhaveti.
Visrajya
Lajyam, Rududusma Suswaram. They wept sonorously, melodiously they wept because they were beeping with bhakti. The Lord tells them, I have my duties to perform. I have to go. The gopis allow him to go. On the way, something happens. As the Lord is sitting in the chariot, Akrura wants to do his Sandhya Vandana, evening time. So he gets into the waters. The Lord is smiling. And as Akrura takes a dip, Keshava Swaha, Narayana Swaha, he has to start. And as he takes a dip, there what does he see?
Shantakaram Bhujagashenam Padmanabham Suresham.
Oh God, the same Krishna who is sitting in the chariot is there in the water. Again he comes out of the water and the Lord says, over, the ritual is over. Wait Krishna, I'm cross-checking. Again one more dip. Again a darshan of Padmanabha Swami. My dear listeners, Achara Prabhu Dharmo Dharmasya Prabhu Rachyutaha. He is the Acharana of all Acharas. Please remember, he is the ritual of rituals. He is the master of rituals. There are moments when you realize that he is everything. The Bhagavata says, Akrura has learnt it. Shri Krishna now goes on to Mathura. On his way to Mathura, he is performing several miracles, and each miracle has a lesson for us. There is a man, a dhobi, a washerman, who has taken the laundry from Kamsa. He has to wash the clothes and bring them clean, neatly iron. And as he's bringing the neat clothes, the Lord says, for whom is this? He says, for the king Kamsa. His head is gone. When you don't offer it to the Lord says, I kill you. I destroy you. What is not offered to the Lord is not at all an offering. Remember, there is no bigger boss than the Lord in the world. A little later, he meets an incense bearer. She is a deformed hunchback woman. Her head is almost touching the ground. She's got a hump on her back. She's carrying a plate of perfumes. And as she comes, slowly walking, she can scarcely walk. Very ugly her form is, but her heart is lovely. As she's walking slowly towards the Lord comes and stands before her and says, for whom are these perfumes? She looks at the feet. They don't seem to be normal feet. Then she looks at the knees. Then she looks at the navel, then she looks at the Vishala Vakshasthala, then she comes to the face of the Lord and says,
Zari ki pagdi bandhe, sundar aankho wala.
For you, Krishna, for you. How can the perfumes be for anybody else, my Lord? The one who has this beautiful bhava gets a beautiful form. The Lord takes his toe and presses her toe, holds her by the chin and swirls her. One quick round and she becomes the most beautiful woman in the world, my dear listeners. What does it mean concept-wise? When you have beautiful bhava, you have a beautiful form. The exterior and the interior are one and the same. And that is how the Lord is pleased with her. To make the long story short, Shri Krishna is entering the boxer's ring. Everybody says, my God, these small children, what are they going to do? And these wrestlers are huge fellows. They are very well seasoned men, boxers of the highest order. How can they ever be a match? These children can never be a match to these royal wrestlers. As they enter the boxer's ring, different people are looking at Krishna and Balrama from different perspectives. When you go to the Bhu Vaikuntha called Tirumala, some call Venkateswara Appa, some call him Amma, some call him brother, some call him father, some call him savior, some call him the King of Kings. Each one has his own bond with the Lord. You can call the Lord whatever you want. You can recognize him as any form of a relative of yours. Here is the shloka saying,
Mallanam Ashanihi.
The Malla Yudhas, the boxers say, oh, he is like the thunderbolt.
Nrinam Naravaraham.
Men said he is the best of men. Women said he is Cupid. Sthrinam Smaro Murtiman.
Gopanam Swajanum.
Whenever you switch on the TV and you say Indian team, our team, that is how the Gopas say, our Krishna, he's from our village.
Asatam Kshitibhujam Shastam.
Those who don't know him, he is the scourge, punishment. That is how the ignorant kings look at him.
Swapitro Shishuhum.
For his parents, Devaki and Vasudeva, he is the little one called Krishna. Your father and mother call you by the pet name. Even if you become the Supreme Court judge, they'll call you Kittu and Pittu. Because for them, you're always the small child. Swapitro Shishuhu. If you ask Kamsa, who is this? He says, don't ask me. Don't you ask me. This is my veritable death. This is the one that was pronounced on the day I took Vasudeva and Devaki on the marriage procession. This is the fellow. This is the eighth child about whom I have been dreading for a long time. Rutyur Bhojapate Virad Avidusham. The Avidwan said, this is the Virat Purusha.
Tatvam Param Yoginam.
The yogis said, this is Yogeshwara. This is Paratattva. This is Parabrahma who has come into the world. Sadhu Paritrana and Dushta Nigraha is his duty.
Vrishninam Paradevate Tividito Rangam Gatasagrajaham.
The Vrishni Vamsha says he has come to save us. He is our savior. The Lord leaps on to Kamsa, brings him down, and is about to give him the death blow. Kamsa realizes this is Narayana himself. The gods in heaven rain flowers and say, the Kamsavada has taken place. The Lord has fulfilled his word of Sadhu Paritrana. At this time, the mother and father don't accept the pranams of Krishna, because they say a child of 12 cannot kill Kamsa. He is not a child. He is Parabrahma. We thought he is our little one. We thought he is our little Krishna. He is not our Krishna. He is the master of the world. What Arjuna realized when he saw the Vishwarupa. For a long time he'd called him Hai Krishna. Hai Yadava. Hey Krishna. Hey Yadava. Hey Saketi. Ajanata Mahimanam Tavedam Mayapramadat Pranayena Vapi. The Lord is asking him, who am I? What am I now?
Pitasi lokasya characharasya
tvamasya pujyascha gurur gariyan natvat samo asti abhyadika kutonyo lokatraye pratima prabhavam. You are the master of masters, the father of fathers, the preceptor of preceptors, the beloved of beloved. There is nobody equal to you arithmetically. How can there be anybody superior to you, Krishna? How can there be anybody superior to you? That is how the parents also realize. The Lord makes Ugrasena the grandfather, that is the father of Kamsa, as the king, and establishes justice. Now we come to a very interesting episode, and that is the episode of Uddhava going to the gopis. The episode now that I place before you is a well-known episode. As usual, there's a tussle between the head and the heart. For years together, the head and the heart have had a battle. And it's always the heart that won. The head has limitations. The heart does not have limitations. My dear listeners, all of us know that in every religion, God is placed in the heart, not in the head. The head can change its decisions, its inventions, but the heart never changes. The heart is the one that makes you humble. The heart, it is that makes you forgive. It is the head that finds faults. It is the head that takes revenge. Bhaktas are not proud. Bhaktas are always humble. Adveshta sarvabhutanam maitra karunayevacha nirmamo nirahankara samadukha sukhakshami. But those who are intelligent, those who are known for their scholarship, they are tending to be proud. That is the case with Uddhava.
Vrishninam pravaro mantri krishnasya daitasakha shishyo brihaspate sakshat uddhavo buddhisattamaha.
biodata, CV. That is the resume of Uddhava. What is it? Vrishninam Pravaro Mantri. He is the Prime Minister of the Vrishnis and Krishna's best friend. And he is the brilliant rank holder, gold medalist student of Brihaspati Acharya, preceptor of the gods, Brihaspati Shishya. Shishyo Brihaspati Sakshat, not correspondent course. He sat in the presence of Sakshat Brihaspati and learned. Well, the master was brilliant. What about the student? Buddhavo Buddhi Sattamaha. He is very, very intelligent. One day the Lord wanted to teach him humility. The Lord wanted to educate him. Please remember, those whom the Lord loves, he wants to make them perfect. Polish, 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 polish. He wants to make them perfect. However painful the process, one has to go through it. One has to go through it. There is no doubt about it. The Lord calls him and holds his hand. Krishna says, my dear, prapannarthi haro harihi grihitva paninam pani, panina pani. He holds him by the hand and says, gachodhava, go where, sir? Vrajam saumya pittornau pritimavaha gopinam mat viyogadhim mat sandesheir vimochaya. Go, go to Vrindavan to meet your parents, yes, and the gopis. Milkmaids, milkmaids of Vrindavan, unlettered milkmaids, bourgeois community. The Lord says, you'll get the shock of your life. Go and meet them and you'll know who they are. You know who they are? Taman manaska mat prana madarthe tyaktadaihika mameva daitam preshtam atmanam manasagata. They live in me, they live by me, I live in them, they live for me. Go and meet them. Go, Uddhava, be careful. Uddhava, the overconfident intellectual. Intellectuals are overconfident always. They think they can face any situation until they break down. There goes Uddhava. Uddhava goes to Vrindavan and meets Nand Baba, and he meets Yashoda. Yashoda is sitting quietly, stupefied, like patience on a monument. And Nand Baba is trying to make conversation. Uddhavji, yes sir, how is, who? Krishna. Your Krishna, our Krishna, I don't know what to call him. He's no more ours. He's become a kingmaker now. He can kill kings and make kings. He has joined politics, high place. He has forgotten this cowherd community. How is he, sir? How is your Krishna, sir? Oh, what do you mean, Swami? What do you mean? You're always his father. She's always his mother. No, sir. Those are forgotten days. He's a big man now. Suddenly, when your child becomes a celebrity, you shrink into a corner. You don't know how to address him. Suddenly, he's become a famous man. The whole world is worshipping him. Become the hero now, limelight. That is how this great one called Nand Baba is talking to him. Look at my wife. Ever since the Lord left, she sits there, totally bereft of joy. Wondering when will he come, she's asking me, when will he come, when will he steal butter, when will I have complaints from the gopis. The whole of Vrindavan is desolate, sir, desolate, barren, abandoned. Nobody's laughed, nobody smiles, nobody is happy because Krishna has gone away. Even the Yamuna is sad, the breeze is sad, the lotuses are sad, the cows are sad, the cowherds are sad, the calves are sad, the birds are silent. We don't know what to do, sir, we don't know what to do. Uddhava understands how these people must be feeling. He says, I was sent by him to only inquire about you because he cares for you, Swami.